He will fight for you, then candidate Donald Trump infamously promised the LGBT community during the 2016 election. If the best person for the job happens to be gay, he would certainly appoint them, he also claimed before winning the White House. Out of hundreds of appointments, apparently there is only one best person for the job who is also openly gay, when a reporter, a lesbian, asked candidate Trump if LGBT people can look for more forward motion on equality. For gay and lesbians, he responded, well, you can, and promised to bring people together, and after the Pulse nightclub massacre in Orlando, Trump even proclaimed that, we are a nation, our heart and soul, is being pro-LGBT. Those were just words which all turned out to be lies. There were more. But Trump's actions have been far, far worse and far more damaging than many ever imagined. Remember Tese? Rescinding Obama-era guidance to protect the civil right of transgender children in schools. Calling for, and still fighting to enact, a total ban on transgender service members in the armed force, including kicking out existing trans people effectively and proudly serving their country. And rescinding Obama-era regulations that ban discrimination against LGBT people in a variety of arenas. Among them, rescinding Obama-era policies that protect transgender workers, and reversing an Obama-era rule banning healthcare discrimination against transgender people. President Trump also instituted an extraordinary policy reversal, prioritizing the right of people of faith over the right of LGBT people. Those are just a few. There are countless other ways President Trump has actively or passively been the most anti-LGBT president in history. He rejected a rule proposed by the Obama administration requiring that same-sex spouses are recognized and afforded equal rights in certain Medicare and Medicaid participating facilities. He has placed a virulently anti-LGBT justice on the U.S. Supreme Court and flooded the federal court with equally, or worse, anti-LGBT judges. One Trump nominee for a lifetime position at U.S. District Court judge proudly admitted they discriminate against gay people, because they're gay. Trump has endorsed several of the most anti-LGBT candidates modern America has ever known. In October of 2017, a reporter told President Trump that Alabama Republican Roy Moore, who ultimately lost his Senate bid despite Trump's endorsement, has said that homosexuality should be illegal and Muslims should be barred from serving in the U.S. Congress, the president refused to denounce those positions. Instead, he told the reporter that the people of Alabama, like Roy, Trump's administration has argued in court against LGBT rights. And reversed Obama-era DOJ position and policies that protected and supported LGBT people. Despite claims from his more moderate supporters who try to market him as the most LGBT supportive Republican to enter the White House, President Trump in fact does not support same-sex marriage, nor the right of transgender people to use restrooms that correspond with their gender identity. But those positions, as offensive and antagonistic as they are, pale in comparison to this president's action targeting LGBT people of all ages. Under Trump, the debt. of justice filedon amicus brief argens actit is acceptable to discriminate against LGBT people in the workplace, stating that the Civil Rights Act of 1964 does not protect homosexuals from discrimination. The appeal court did not agree with the Trump administration's position that anti-gay discrimination is not sex discrimination, ruling that it is. Let's not forget the Trump administration is supporting the religious right by submitting an amicus brief arguing in favor of anti-gay discrimination in the US. Supreme Court case due to be decided on this month. That case will determine if people and businesses can actively discriminate against LGBT people and same-sex couples merely by claiming their religious beliefs requires them to do so. In response, the Trump administration is actually, a one LGBT editor puts it, telling the Supreme Court, that anti-gay discrimination isn't a bad racial discrimination, there is so much more. Trump's policy of refusing and deporting people coming to America to seek asylum is a direct assault on LGBT people, many of whom make the arduous trip from countries in Central America where gay, lesbian, bisexual, and especially transgender people are frequently victims of age violence and murder just for being LGBT. Their government do little to nothing to protect them. Last month a 33-year-old transgender woman, Roxana Hernandez, also spelled Roxana, who had been gang raped, finally reached the US. After traveling for nearly 2 months from Honduras, she did in ICE custody after being locked up for 5 days in what is commonly referred to as an ICE box named, surprisingly, enough, not for the Immigration and Customs Enforcement Agency, but because it is an intentionally cold or near freezing room designed to punish immigrants caught by ICE and the Border Patrol. Trans people in my neighborhood are killed and chopped into pieces and dumped inside potato bags, Hernandez had told BuzzFeed in April. They kill trans people in Honduras. I'm scared of that, immigrant group charges at ICE murder Hernandez. Again, these are just a few of the examples of Trump and the Trump administration's decidedly antagonistic and offensively discriminatory use of the executive branch and the judicial branch via nomination to literally harm LGBT people. Our Christian Heritage candidate Trump told attendees at the 2016 Value Vote Summit, an annual convention hosted by the anti-gay age group Family Research Council, will be cherished, defended, protected like you've never seen before, that's one promise is kept. In 2017 Trump returned, becoming the first sitting president to address the anti-LGBT group. President Trump in fact has embraced Christian evangelicals and this presidency has been a gift for their enduring support. Trump signed an executive order effectively instructing the IRS to ignore the 6-decade-old Johnson Amendment, which banned churches and other tax-exempt religious organizations from campaigning for and donating to candidates, effectively allowing them to become super PACs. That will certainly help the anti-gay Christian right support candidate who wants to further marginalize LGBT people. Trump hasn't been satisfied harming LGBT people here at home. His stage debt, starting in May of 2017, began denying visa to the gay men attempting to flee Chechnya's government-sponsored concentration camp. The authoritarian ruler Ramzan Kadyrov, closely tied to Russian President Vladimir Putin, allowed gay men to be kidnapped, tortured, and murdered in the Khan, which and the Russian government denied even existed. A nominated now former Kansas governor Sam Brownback to become his U.S. ambassador at large for international religious freedom. Brownback, a right-wing religious extremist, is tied tightly to anti-gay age group including the Family Research Council and the American Family Association. He also has ties to the secretive anti-LGBT organization known as the Family, that helped promote Uganda's Kill the Gay Bill. A governor, Brownback actually revoked an executive order made years earlier by his predecessor which made it illegal to discriminate against LGBT state employees. Despite, or because of, his record on LGBT issues, the GOP led Senate confirmed Brownback's nomination. It should also be noted that Republican Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell also, just last month, appointed long-time anti-gay age group leader Tony Perkins of the Family Research Council to a two-year term on a federal government commission tasked with investigating and reporting on international religious freedoms violations. Perkins will now sit on the United States Commission on International Religious Freedom, an independent body that attaches a history of advancing the agenda of America's Evangelical Christian Movement, George Mason University Graduate School Professor Gabriel S. Hudson, Ph. Calls Trump relationship with far-right Christian evangelicals mutually parasitic. In October of last year, America learned that their president had joked that Vice President Mike Pence won't wrong all gay people. Candidate Donald Trump's choice of Pence to become his VP was not just a slap in the face to the LGBT community and Dali, it was a harbinger of the attacks on the LGBT community to come. Pence, rightly, is viewed as even more anti-LGBT than Trump, while the US President clearly has few strong personal beliefs, his vice president has been described as a religious anti-gay zealot by those who know him. Pence is deeply, albeit quietly, embedded into the far Christian right. And it's through Pence's ties to religious swing nuts that Trump has been able to keep his approval rating from dropping even further. In fact, those who once called themselves the moral majority are now the top supporter of the twice-divorced serial lying billionaire who has bragged about committing sexual assault while paying hush money to at least one porn star. Trump has encouraged Pence's religious beliefs to not just be accepted into the White House, but embraced in the Oval Office. Trump has literally prayed while sitting at the historic Resolute Desk with some of the most powerful professional anti-gay peddlers and hucksters of hate. View image on Twitter Johnny Moore @Johnny M. Such an honor to pray within the Oval Office for @Potu. 6h08, juillet 11, 2017, 7,614,8,889 people are talking about this Twitter ADS info and privacy among them, a Pat Robertson's Christian Broadcasting Network gloated, Tony Perkins, President of the Family Research Council, FRC, Pastor John Agee, Founder and Senior Pastor of Cornerstone Church in San Antonio, Paula White, Senior Pastor of New Destiny Christian, The Texas Megachurch Preacher and Fox News Pundit who falsely calls gay people filthy, perverse, and prone to disease, is also falsely claimed there is a link between homosexuality and pedophilia, view image on Twitter Drive. Robert Jeffress coche noir arrobas Robert Jeffress honor de tout près for my friend arrobas real Donald Trump at tonight is Dallas.